Live. Welcome to Peat and Pajamas, a short little excerpt into Peat whilst wearing some pajamas. It's 4 o'clock in the morning here in Seoul, South Korea, and I'm overtired, I'm undertired, I'm jet lagged, I've got a bit of a cold. I haven't posted a video for about, is it 2 weeks now? So it's time to get back into things and give you a little bit of interesting content here. Who else is wearing pajamas out there? Looks like I'm live now. Okay, so now I'm live. Well, I thought I was live already. Welcome to Peat in Pajamas here on Whisky Whistle. I'm your host, Mark. It's 4 o'clock in the morning here in Seoul, South Korea. Hence, I'm wearing my pajamas. I've got a bit of a cold. I haven't posted content for over about 2 weeks now. And, well, it's time to get back into things with a bit of peat. Some peat to cure this cold. And let me just get into my control room here. Thanks for joining. I don't know if anybody's here yet. If you are, that's great. Let's get started here. We're going to start with Macri Moor. This is the Iron Malts Peated Whiskey. Let's get that open. 10 seconds in, it looks like. And the stream status is good. Well, that's good to know. It says it's 1 minute 20 now. Okay. Well, it's time to start looking at... I don't know where I find it. Here we go. Okay, someone's here. It's Andrew. All right. Hey, Andrew and Andy Walker. Well, thanks for joining. So, Macri Moor. This is the cask strength batch number 3. No, batch 2. The second edition, 2015. Get that poured just a little bit. It's very late. Well, early, I should say. It's late for me. I've been up all night. I had a bit of work to do and finish it all up, and it's I thought, you know what, it's time to give myself a little bit of a present. So the present is whiskey. All right, so Macri Moor. This is peated to about 20%, and it's an island malt from the Isle of Arran. Pardon me. I think it's about 20 ppm apparently. Now this is 58.7%. 58.2, so that's a heavy hitter. I'm starting with this one because of its low peating. Since it's actually the highest in proof, I could put it at the end, but, and here comes my cold. All right, we've got Aqvavitae in. Thank you for joining, Roy. Really great time on your show. I guess that was about, 10 days ago now? Anyway, it's got a really lovely aroma though. And I'm so happy that I can smell whiskey again. I couldn't smell anything up until yesterday. It smells like a nice mixture of fruit and caramel and peat. Beautiful. Let's give that a try. I have no idea what I'm doing here. What's with the pajamas? I don't know. I thought it would be funny. I wish I had a hat. And WhiskyThrottle, thank you for joining. That's great. Now, apparently, I've only got about 20 minutes. This will have to be the prelude to the Scotch Test Dummies Live. Anyway, let's move along. That was, that's nice. Such a long finish. What I like about Arran is this interesting, it's kind of like what I would imagine banana leaves might smell or taste like. Kind of waxy, kind of sweet, kind of banana-esque. Anyway, 20 minutes, lots of time. Yes, let's try. The next one is Kilchoman. Now, this is one that I have yet to show on the channel. Same with Macri Moor, actually. And I've been holding out. I like this a lot. And, we'll try a little bit together, shall we? Have you tried Kilchoman? Now, that's... Okay, I should have probably... opened that up a while ago. That was a bit stiff. Okay, second one, Kilchoman. This one is 46%, 700 milliliters from the Isle of Islay. Hide that label on the glass. I don't know, how do I look? I can't see how I look. Do I look all right? I hope so. I hope I haven't cut off my head. I've done that in the past. And Aaron, yes, peated whiskey is a panacea for what ails you. Yes, I agree. All right. Now this one is sherry, right? Sherry matured. Sherry cask matured, right? Nice rich color. Much more peat here now. I think this is about 45%. This is what I was told by the young son. He came to Korea. Pardon me, I've forgotten his name. I know one of them, their names is right here. Willis. So the young Willis, he came to Korea and we had a bit of a tasting and that was nice. All right. Much more peat. It is a bit young though. You really get that bonfire, especially with young peat. The sherry comes through though. It's got some nice sweetness to it. That's great. All right, over into the chat room. Yes, I look dapper. Well, thank you. And sleepy. Yes, I'm a little bit sleepy. I don't know. My body doesn't know what time it is. I'm jet lagged. I came from Winnipeg a few days ago. I guess about nearly a week ago now. Still a little bit jet lagged, partially because of my own, we'll call it my own bad habits of staying up late. And also having work to do that needed to be done, and I wish I didn't have to do it, and I'm soon to quit that. So, good. All right, third one. Can you guess what that is? Any guesses? I survived the Korean New Year. Yes, I did. In fact, it was a little bit easier than usual. We only stayed out of our house just one night. In the past, it's been as long as many as 2 or 3 days of sleeping in relatives' houses. I'm here in Korea, Seoul, South Korea, and my wife is Korean. My children, I've got 3 beautiful children, 3 girls. They are, well, half Canadian, half Korean in terms of their DNA makeup. Of course, they're 100% Korean and 100% Canadian culturally. I'll let you think about that one. All right, so, yes, Andrew, BenRiach. All right. Which BenRiach? And that is the Septendecim. Now, one of the reasons why I wanted to do this little live, again, it's just been, it's been 2 weeks since I've put out content. That's the longest I've ever done without a show since I started, I think. So we're going to go with the BenRiach Septendecim, which means 17. And I say that because way back when, I didn't have an idea. I didn't have a clue what septendecim meant. I don't learn Latin. All right, so let's get that poured just a little bit. Well, I'm very happy. Oh, I meant to... Oh, I've got the light turned out. Oh, my God. This is a big fail right now. Just give me 1 second. I'm going to peep over here for 1 split second. Oh, my God. And we have light. Which day was there light? On the first day, I believe. Okay, so now you can see that really nicely, I think. Boom! We have light. All right. another reason why I wanted to do this quick little live. I wanted to let you know that, well, I did actually launch recently a Patreon account. So that's patreon.com/whiskywhistle, patreon.com/whiskywhistle, whisky, no E, whistle, whiskey whistle. Now, I haven't put a whole lot in there yet. That is yet to come. I am going to arrange, rewards, what's going to happen if you are a supporter of X amount per show or per month, and so on. And I think there'll be a few different things going on. Probably one will be an email, sort of a blog, kind of like a blog, but just for those, the Patreon supporters. That'll be the basic level. That will occur at least once a month. All right, so we'll get started with that. Beyond that, I haven't decided yet, so you stay tuned. Okay, right, and we have Duane Large. Hello, Duane Large. I hope you're living large, Duane. All right, so this was the BenRiach Septendecim. And just a big, a boom of this candy sweetness, kind of like the white candies, not the clear ones, but the white ones that are almost squishy. They're not quite crunchy, not quite soft, but they're kind of they sort of crumble in your teeth. This is what that reminds me of. And yet alongside there is this very earthy, very fragrant and approachable peat. If you want an approachable peat for someone or for yourself, this is a good one to try. Cheers. Now I can't keep track of the chat room very well. Thank you so much. I've got quite a few people here. Can I see how many there are? I can't see how many there are. At least four. All right, so at least four people here, maybe five or six. So glad you could come. One more comment about this. As you'd expect from the BenRiach, it is candy and fruit. Little wafts of peat in there. I would say this is kind of like Lagavulin, we'll call it Lagavulin light. Now, I don't mean that to be an offense. What I mean is that same package of sweet and peat you're getting here, but the peat is toned down and the sweet is a little bit more candy-esque and I think bourbon influenced rather than the sherry influence you get from Lagavulin. Very lovely. That's number three. On to number four. How are we doing for time here? Let's check. Do you like my thumbnail? 12 minutes. Okay, I got 8 minutes to go. Martin, thank you for joining. I gotta look over here. My chat room's there. My camera's here. Thank you for joining. It's a little bit of a Peat event here. Peat and pajamas. I hope I'm not having a wardrobe malfunction. All right, next is Laphroaig PX. PX cask. Let's get rid of the canister. As you can see, I'm kind of fumbling here a little bit with the setup, but there we go. Good enough. And this is number four now. So far we've had the Aaron Macri Moore, Kilhoman Loch Gorm. That's how you say it, I'm not sure. Then the BenRiach Septendecim, and now Laphroaig PX cask. We're kind of going upwards in ABV, except for the first, which was the lowest in peat. So just a little bit for our tasting right now. Martin, welcome. And Jason, I'm not drunk whatsoever. What about you? I started very late. I had a quick dram with my wife before she went to bed. That was nice. We had a little bit of Glenmorangie Tane. The Tane. In fact, it was a bottle kill, and it's right here. I ripped off the label because I saved myself 50 milliliters in a little sample bottle, and I pasted that metallic foil onto the sample. Actually, I've got it right here just to show you. Look at this. See what you can do? Isn't that cool? So it's almost like an official, semi-official, pseudo-official Glenmorangie Tane, the Amontillado sherry cask finish. Learning things as I go here, the pronunciation of Amontillado. All right, so that was the Laphroaig, and I'm missing so much here. Roy says, lovely flavors, but the texture was very thin to me. Now, let's have a little comparison. Yeah, I love the nose. Again, you take that that booming, that just face-punching 10-year-old, and you mellow it out in Pedro Jimenez sherry casks. and you get this just very perfumey, sweet, again, candy shop kind of a scent coming through here. No more bandages. And it the smell, the scent reminds me of the 15-year-old to a degree. All right, and the palate. Yeah, for 48%, you'd expect a little bit more of an oiliness to it. I can see where he's coming from. And again, missing so much here. Yes, Jason, yes, my wife is Korean. We've been married now coming up on 9 years. In fact, we met 10 years ago. I think I had a bit of a fail. I missed the 10-year first date anniversary. That was bad. So I'm going to have to make up for that. The 9th anniversary and then something amazing for the 10th anniversary. I will accept your recommendations. Not just Jason's, everyone's. There's someone named Jillian here. Hello, Jillian. Thank you for joining. And Andy Walker, thanks for sticking around so long. All right. Let's get on to the next one, number 5. What's number 5 going to be? It is a very wide bottle. And it looks like this. Again, this I picked up here in Korea in the secondhand, kind of, it's like first-hand, secondhand markets. They do both purchasing from suppliers, but they also will buy from anyone wanting to unload whatever they might have. Koreans give a lot of whiskey as gifts, and I think a lot of Koreans actually don't drink whiskey, the ones who get the gifts. Rather than keep it and give it to a guest, you see in Korea, you open a bottle, you finish the bottle. So if you're not a whiskey drinker, then you don't keep whiskey around. You're better off having some wine or maybe some soju, something that can be consumed in one sitting. Whiskey Throttle, thanks for joining. All right. And let's get on to Buna Haben. Help me with this one. Krakmona. I haven't done the research yet for that one. This is 50% ABV. This is a travel retail specialty. It's a peated Buna Haben, so that's a little bit special. I really, really wanted a nice Buna Haben, and I think I found one. This one is so, so ashy, smoky, bonfire. But not the not the nose, especially the palate after you keep it in your mouth for a little while. And again, I don't know why my corks are so dry. I think because it's been a bit cold here this winter, so the air is much drier than usual. All right. Go Habs, welcome. Thank you for joining a very impromptu live event here. This is Peat and Pajamas, number 1. We'll see how many of these we do. I think at least one more. I'll show you all of my different pajamas. again, I hope I don't have a wardrobe malfunction. I'd hate to have one of my man breasts pop out. did I just say that? Oh my God. Okay. Again, I have no idea what I look like, so hopefully it's pleasing to some of you in some regard. And if I've missed your comments, I apologize. It's pretty hard doing this alone. Okay, so again, this Buna Haben on the nose. It smells like Buna Haben, but just with a little bit of a puff of peat there. And actually the nose reminds me also a little bit of Lecheg, the peated Tobermory. Especially the 10-year-old. That might also give me an inkling as to the age. I asked someone from the company about age and casks and so on, and they just told me that it's all secret. Is it really a secret? You know, that's really especially for that company, to play that game, I felt a little bit disappointed. I hate to say it. What can I say? All right. But don't forget, let's always let the whiskey do the talking, right? Okay. Uh-oh. Thank you, Roy. I really appreciate that. We're going to wrap this up in just one more whiskey. All right. Now, if that Lafroig was a bit thin on the palate, this one's very oily. And again, the longer you keep it in your mouth, the more peaty rewards you get. Hopefully I'm decent. Don't worry, it's not like a kilt. Nothing scary is going to pop out of here. Boy, I'm sure quipping the gems out tonight, aren't I? If you're a peat fan, especially things like Lafroig 10-year-old, Ardbeg 10, I highly recommend that one. Okay, the final peated whiskey of the night. Oh yes, I finally opened it. I had this for a very long time. In fact, I think I kept it for over 2 years before opening it. Probably shouldn't have done that. I should have kept it. Oh well. That is Ardbeg Ugadal. All right. Now I've had it. Boy, I'm already a third into that already. This one is 54.2%. And arguably the peatiest in terms of the fact that it is Ardbeg. 50 ppm, plus it's way over 50%. So you're getting a big, big peat component here. Hide the label on that one too. And a nice little pour. There we go. That's just enough for now. And yes, thank you, Andrew. I thought so. And dancing some K-pop. Well, I don't know if, again, yes, then definitely the wardrobe malfunction will happen if I do a bit of K-pop hip-hoppity K-pop dancing. All right. So, color-wise, that's definitely the darkest. But it doesn't say anything about natural color on here. I wish it did. Some people have tried to tell me that it's definitely natural in color. I'm just not sure. It certainly is non-chill filtered. And I would say it's definitely older than the 10-year-old. It's probably the 10-year-old and then with the finishing in the sherry casks. Does it say which sherry casks again? No, it just says X sherry casks. All right. Nosing. It's certainly the briniest of the bunch. And it's also really got this really nice raisiny and yet peaty nose. Very nice. Go Habs, thank you. Yes, I'll see you there. All right, on to the palate. If you're a peat head, this one is the winner. It certainly has the deepest peat. It's also got this very rich sherry component that is very nice. And what I love about this one is when you add a bit of water, then we add a little bit more. And you know, don't be shy with the water. Don't just do the one drop or whatever. That really, I just don't think that does anything. And I'm not the only one who thinks so. There's also scientific papers that'll back me up on that one, especially if you're starting with 54%. So a single drop, no. Try a milliliter of water, maybe two. All right. When you add water to this, you really get this earthy, bready bake shop component coming through. And the raisins are still there and the peat's still there. It's very nice. Amongst my friends, this is the peat winner, especially among my friend Joel, who's probably not watching here now, but he will eventually. Cheers, Joel. What I liken that is, what I liken this to is dark Danish or German rye bread toasted with butter on it. And you got that rye, the Danish rye coming through there, and caraway. And then, of course, you're next to the bonfire. Well, anyway, hope you enjoyed that. Now, again, I mentioned that once. I'll mention it again. I've got lots of things coming up on the channel that I want to share with you. And, well, I don't want to do this alone. So why not join up with Team Whisky Whistle on Patreon, patreon.com/WhiskyWhistle. And we're going to start with all Patreon supporters. And the first one has already come aboard, and he was here earlier. Thank you very much again. And that's going to be a monthly little newsletter from me sent to your email. Hopefully that is something that you would enjoy. I'll tell you about what's going on with my life, with the whisky journey, with a little bit about my family as well. And hopefully you'd enjoy that and appreciate that. Anyway, so check that out. And let's get on to the live with the Scotch Test Dummy. So let's give a little plug. Why not jump over to the Scotch Test Dummies? They're right now putting out a live event. And this is live with Glenfiddich Tracy, Tracy Franklin. Okay, so I've overlapped by a few minutes. Let's join them. I'm gonna say goodbye. Thank you for joining. I know this was a very sudden, very impromptu live. I really appreciate that. Some last minute comments here. We have a Jean-Paul Vanderhoven. All right, good, thank you. Yes, please do drink your whiskeys, your peated whiskeys in your pajamas. Peat and pajamas, number one. This was Mark from Whisky Whistle saying thank you. Goodbye, everyone. If I missed your comments, I'll check those out right away, and we'll see you soon. Goodbye.
Oh, how do I stop this?
I'm gonna have to turn this around. Oh my god. And stop. Stop. Okay, thank you. Goodbye. I don't know how to shut this off. Oh my. Bye everyone. Thank you. There it is. Live, okay. Yes, I want to stop streaming. Okay, thank you. Goodbye.